गुड मॉर्निंग किड्स, वेलकम टू टुडेज इंग्लिश क्लास। किड्स, आर यू रेडी टू एंजॉय योर क्लास? ओके, प्रीवियस क्लास वी स्टार्ट द चैप्टर फ्रॉम ए लिटरेचर टेक्स्ट बुक, चैप्टर 4। एंड व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ अवर चैप्टर? ए गोरिल्ला इन द गेस्ट रूम। एंड वी नो अवर बेबी गोरिल्ला बाय नेम एनपोंगो। वी आर स्टडिंग अबाउट दैट एनपोंगो। And the previous class, I didn't mention about the author of the story, and I gave an activity for you to read about the author. Then I got your audio clips. I enjoyed your audio clips, and now we know about the author. Who was the author of the story? The author of our story is Gerard Durrell. And The story, a gorilla in the guest room was extracted from his walk, manger manner. Okay, kids. So, shall we move to our story? Okay, we know here our speaker. Okay, just quickly recap what we did in the previous class. Okay, here our speaker, and we know our speaker has his Sue, and this Sue is not. Financially is not good, but the speaker got a chance to add a baby gorilla in his zoo. Then he decided to collect that baby gorilla. For that, he reached the London airport and he went to the place and he got a baby gorilla. Before that, we know he was worrying about something. What was that? He thought that maybe he will get a chimpanzee instead of a baby gorilla. But finally, he got a baby gorilla. And what is the name of our baby gorilla? Npongo. Then, one more thing, kids. Gorilla. Gorilla means it's an ape, and so only found in Africa. And we know apes are not monkeys. They look like a human beings, and they can do the things of a human. So then, now the speaker got that baby gorilla, and we know the name of our baby gorilla is Npongo. Then the second paragraph is explaining about the physical appearance. The baby gorilla was very handsome and very healthy, and he has 18 inches height, and his fur was very glossy and chocolate brownish colored fur, and it was very glossy and height, and his fur was very glossy and chocolate brownish colored fur, and it was very glossy, and his eyes look like a chip of coal. Then the next one, we know the baby gorilla Npongo was a very keen observer. That's why he observed our speaker very clearly. Then the next one, we understood that the baby gorilla Npongo know how to eat, and he knows good manners. That's why he ate that banana very daily, or he ate that banana in a small bites instead of other chimpanzees. Other chimpanzees stuffed that banana into their mouth, but here our baby gorilla Npongo ate that banana in a small bite. So the speaker was very happy to adopt that baby and gorilla Npongo to his zoo. Then they reached their place Jersey, and bypassing the road, our Npongo was observing everything, and he saw the cows, everything he saw, and he enjoyed the traveling. Then they reached the zoo. Our Npongo's cage was not ready, so our speaker decided to keep our Npongo in his guest room. Then his speaker's mother, friends, and everyone came to their From the first sight itself, they attracted baby gorilla, because Npongo know how to behave. He shows polite towards others, he respect others, and he shows good manners. That's why all of them loved Npongo very much, and they treated Npongo as a king. Okay, my kids, up to that we stopped in previous class. Okay, next we can do the next part. Okay, take your test book in your hand, and you know, underline the important words there and look into your test book. Okay. Having previously kept Chimli, the chimpanzee, in the house, I know from bitter experience that an ape could quickly turn a civilized room into something closely resembling a bomb set. Kumli. Okay, then our speaker had a gorilla. Then what was the name of that gorilla? Chumli. And the chimpanzees. So then the speaker says about the bitter experience he got from that chimpanzee. What happened? Our chimpanzee Kumli turned a beautiful room into a bomb site. That means that much naughty was that Kumli. That's why the speaker was fear about chimpanzees. Then Pongo, like a hawk, when he became bored with lying on the sofa, he decided to circle the room to look at anything of interest. Then the speaker was watching Npongo. Then the speaker said that when the Npongo was became bored, he circled the room to look at anything interest. He walked slowly around like a tiny professor in a museum, pausing now to look at a picture, now to stroke an ornament, but doing it so gently that there was never any danger that he would break anything. Then the speaker was keenly observing what was Npongo doing there. So Npongo, if the Npongo get bored, he make a walk in that place like a tiny professor. He looked everything, he took that ornaments, he took different pictures, everything. But one thing is, he take care of that thing. He didn't damage anything. He never damaged anything in that place, or he never make he never damage or he never break anything in that place. Very slowly, very careful way he handled all the things and in that place. After the attitude I was used to with Kumli, I was thrilled with Npongo's beautiful behavior. Now the speaker was comparing that baby chimpanzee Kumli with Npongo. Both has different behaviors. The Kumli was very naughty and he he broke everything in there, and he turned all the civilized, a beautiful room into a room like a beautiful room into a room like a place like a bombed site. But here Npongo was take care of everything, and he is handling very carefully, and he didn't break anything, and he didn't make any damage to anything in that place. After the attitude, okay my kids, now we can move to the second paragraph. He behaved very well, so well that by the time we put him to bed, my mother asked me if we could keep him in the house permanently. But remembering Kumli's behavior, I turned a deaf ear to her pleas. Then he behaved very well and he shows good manners. That's why my mother asked me to keep our Npongo in that guest room or in that house permanently. Our mother asked, don't take Npongo to the zoo, or don't take Npongo from here. We can keep Npongo here because he knows how to use everything perfectly and politely. But I know gorillas or baby gorillas change their behavior. Sometimes there is a chance to do naughty things by them. So I didn't put my ears to my mother. I ignored my mother's request. Appa amma parayunu namaki baby gorilla Npongo ne namaku nammude veettile thaamasippikkanu. Pakshe endu petti Npongo chelappo Npongo ini vella naughty aayittu maariyalo adu kaaranam അവൻ നമ്മുടെ സ്പീക്കർ എന്ത് വിചാരിച്ചു, അമ്മയുടെ വാക്കുകൾ ശ്രദ്ധിച്ചില്ല. സ്പീക്കറിന് എന്താ പേടി? പ്രീവിയസ് ടൈം ദർ വാസ് എ ചിമ്പാൻസി ബൈ നെയിം ചുംലി, ആൻഡ് ദാറ്റ് ചിമ്പാൻസി വാസ് വെരി നോട്ടി ആൻഡ് ഹി ബ്രോക്കൺ എവറിഥിങ് ഇൻ ദാറ്റ് ഹൗസ് ആൻഡ് ഹി മെയ്ഡ് ദാറ്റ് ഹൗസ് ഇൻ ടു എ പ്ലേസ് ലൈക്ക് എ ബോംബ് സൈറ്റ്. ഒരു ബോംബ് വീണ ഒരു പ്ലേസ് എങ്ങനെ ഡേഞ്ചർ ഡാമേജ്ഡ് ആവോ അതുപോലെയാണ് നമ്മുടെ ചുംലി എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ചിമ്പാൻസി ആ വീട് മാറ്റിക്കളഞ്ഞു. അതുകൊണ്ടാണ് നമ്മുടെ സ്പീക്കറിന് ഒരു പേടിയുള്ളത്. Npongo ഓഫ് കോഴ്സ് ഡിഡ് നോട്ട് ലീവ് ദ ഗസ്റ്റ് റൂം ഇൻ ദ കണ്ടീഷൻ ദാറ്റ് ഹി ഫൗണ്ട് ഇറ്റ്. ബട്ട് ദിസ് വാസ് ഓൺലി ടു ബി എക്സ്പെക്ടഡ്. ഓൾദോ ഹിസ് മാനേഴ്സ് വെർ എക്സലന്റ്, ഹി വാസ് ഓൺലി എ ബേബി. ദൻ ഓഫ് കോഴ്സ് Npongo ഡിഡ് മേക്ക് എനി ചേഞ്ചസ് ഓർ എനി ഡാമേജസ് ഇൻ ദാറ്റ് ഹൗസ്. ബട്ട് സംതിങ് ലിറ്റിൽ മിസ്റ്റേക്സ് ഓൾസോ മെയ്ഡ് ബൈ അവർ Npongo ദാറ്റ് വി ക്യാൻ എക്സ്പെക്ട് ബിക്കോസ് ഹി വാസ് എ ബേബി. ഒരു കുഞ്ഞായതുകൊണ്ട് ചെറിയ ചെറിയ കുസൃതി തരമൊക്കെ അവൻ കാണിക്കുന്നുണ്ട്. Then, so the guest room when he left it bore many traces of his presence. One wall, for instance, was something that resembled a map of Japan. Then one day I find out that our wall, say picture, it's that picture looks like a map of Japan. Then I understood that was done by Npongo. When Npongo, they are done by Npongo. This was nicely drawn in starlight and was due to the fact that I had thought Npongo might like some tin raspberries. He had liked them, and his enthusiasm at this new food has resulted in the map of Japan. So then the speaker find out the fact that the speaker gave Npongo raspberries. Raspberries means this type of small red fruits, and that was the first time Npongo tasting raspberries. Because of that enthusiasm, Npongo draw the picture on the wall, and it looked like a map of a Japan. There was also the incident. So this was the first incident. Then the second one, there was also the incident with the door. Npongo, after eating his meal, had tried to follow me out of the room. Then the speaker is saying about the next incident done by our small baby gorilla Npongo. He knew that the handle by some magical means open and close the door, but he didn't know how to exact know exactly how to use it. So then the second incident was, every day, every time Npongo watched very closely that the speaker is using the handle of the door to open and close it. Then finally, the Npongo imitated that. Then one day, Npongo know this door is used for closing. This handle is using for closing and opening the door. But Npongo didn't know how to use that handle. Know exactly how to use it. So he had pulled it downwards with all his strength. As I tried unsuccessfully to bend the handle back into position again, I reflected that Npongo was only about 2 years old. His strength would certainly increase along with his size. Then Npongo also tried to open and close the door by using their handle. But what happens? That was damaged. So the speaker can't repair that handle, and speaker can't replace that handle into back position. And the speaker understood that Npongo was very small, but with all of his strength, he used to open that door by using that handle, and now the handle became damaged. So that was the second incident. First incident, the speaker gave Npongo raspberries as food, and by the enthusiasm, Npongo draw a picture on the wall by using this raspberries. Raspberries is a small red colored fruit, and that picture drawn by Npongo was look like a map of a Japan. The second incident was, we know Npongo was very keen observer, so every time he observed this how the speaker is using the door's handle to close and open it. So Npongo also imitated that, but it became damaged. Then, because he was friendly, had good manners and good sense of humor, Npongo quickly became the darling of the zoo. Then we know Npongos have very good manners and good sense of humor. Because of that, he became the darling pet of that zoo. One warm afternoon, he was brought out onto the lawn in front of the hedge, and there he would show off to his admirers, either lying in the grass with a broad expression on his face or with a wicked look in his eyes, working out how he could pose for his photograph to be taken with some earnest visitor. Then this so we know visitors will come here. Then the visitors can take photos with our Npongo. Maybe sometimes the Npongo pose in a happy manner. Other times his face became very bold. So we can get different poses of our pics of our Npongo. He would then rush forward at the most important moment and grab the unfortunate photographer's leg. Then one day, while the photographer is taking photo, then Pongo ran and grabbed the photographer's leg. This gave him great amusement. However, it generally resulted in an excellent picture of a completely empty section of note. At that time, the photographer took that photo, and how was that photo look? And the photo is very beautiful photo and the very beautiful picture of that lawn that the speaker ever see. സ്പീക്കർ ഒരിക്കലും കാണാത്ത അത്രയും മനോഹരമായിട്ടുള്ള ഒരു ലോണിൻ്റെ പിക്ചറാണ് അന്ന് കിട്ടിയത്. ഹൗ ദ ദിസ് ഫോട്ടോഗ്രാഫർ ടേക്ക് ദ പിക്ചർ അറ്റ് ഫോട്ടോഗ്രാഫർ അറ്റ് ദ ടൈം ദ ഫോട്ടോഗ്രാഫർ ഇസ് ഫോക്കസിംഗ് ദ പിക്ചർ പിക്ചേഴ്സ് ഓഫ് എൻപോങ്കോ ആൻഡ് ദ വിസിറ്റേഴ്സ് എൻപോങ്കോ ഗ്രാബ് ദിസ് ഫോട്ടോഗ്രാഫേഴ്സ് ലെഗ് ആൻഡ് അൺഫോർച്ചുനേറ്റ്ലി ഓർ സഡൻലി ദ ഫോട്ടോഗ്രാഫർ ടേക്ക് ദാറ്റ് ഫോട്ടോ ആൻഡ് ഇറ്റ്സ് ദ പിക്ചർ ദ of a lawn, empty beautiful lawn. Okay my kids, this is our chapter. It's a small chapter about a baby gorilla by name Npongo and a speaker, and we know how much the speaker loved Npongo and how much Npongo living, how much Npongo is entertaining others, and how much Npongo was happy in that place Jersey with the living with the speaker. Then the next one is the incidents or the funny moments or the naughty things, not funny happy incidents that made by Npongo. We mainly discussed in this class. We understood three main incidents. We find out one was the picture drawn by Npongo looked like a map of a Japan. And he used the thing he used to draw the picture is raspberries. Then the second is he imitated the speaker and he used the handle of the door to open and close it, and that became damaged. The third one is about the photographs taken by the photographer of the Npongos and visitors. And one day the photographer is taking their photo. Npongo grabbed photographer's leg, and the result was a picture. They got a picture, it's a beautiful empty lawn, and the speaker said there's a beautiful, most beautiful picture that I ever seen in about my lawn. Okay my kids, this was the story, and it's written by Gerald Durrell, and this is his own experience. This story was the speaker, the writer's own experience. So it's a beautiful story. I believe all of you love this story. Okay, my kids, now use your activity time. Your activities, you know, write the notes. The first thing, write the notes and send me the notes as your according to your roll numbers. Then the second one is read this chapter, go through the new words and spellings. And the third one is your writing activity. Your writing activity is here. Does Npongo behave remind you of a small child? Okay, we know if you are a small child, we know we will do naughty things, we will show good manners, everything we notice, the kids we show everything. So write a short paragraph about that. Write a short paragraph about your childhood. Okay. About your childhood. What all naughty things you did at that time and how you enjoyed your childhood. Okay. You can mention about your friends, your games, everything you can mention, and write a beautiful paragraph about your childhood, my kids. Before winding up the class, we can go through the important words. The first word here in this class, we go through the first word is attitude. Attitude means here a way of behaving. Then second one is turned a deaf ear to. Deaf ear means ignore someone when they ask for something or complain about something. Then scarlet. Scarlet means bright red. Then raspberries. Raspberries means a type of fruits, a small red color fruit. And the third one is earnest. Earnest means serious and determined. Okay kids, thank you for watching and listening me. Do your box, enjoy your day, take care of your health. Thank you.